Super impressed at the results I'm getting so far on this WeBoost DriveX RV cell phone signal booster. Now, you've probably heard of these before. Maybe you've seen a lot of mixed reviews. Some people say they do nothing at all. And maybe you camp in places where you have a decent cell signal already. And so you think, why would you really want a cell phone booster in the first place? And that's exactly the camp that I was in up until recently. Now, a few months back, as a family, we took a trip to a remote state park, and the cell reception was horrible. We would have sometimes one bar, it would cut in and out. Sometimes we'd have no service. We couldn't call, we couldn't text, we couldn't get to the internet. Now, you might be thinking, well, you're on vacation. Why do you need to have a cell signal? Well, if you're like me, you still have to work when you're on vacation, and the internet is your gateway to work. And so having a reliable internet connection is really important. And so it was really, really rough. Now, fortunately, we had some family nearby, and so I was able to go over to their place and binge off their internet connection. But every time we'd go back to the RV, we couldn't make calls, we couldn't get texts. The signal was in and out. It was really, really rough. And so all that caused me to rethink looking into these cell phone signal boosters. Now, my impression on these before trying one personally is that they're expensive and they work in a very limited environment. And so why bother? Well, let me show you the results that I'm getting on this one that I installed here, and then I'll show you how easy it is to install. Now, I wanted to precisely know just how much the cell phone signal booster was working. So I went ahead and downloaded this free app from the App Store called Network Signal Info. And there's a bunch of them out there. This is the one I got. Most of them are free. So it's called Network Signal Info, and you can see it just gives you a more detailed look at your cell connection there. So right now it's showing that we have 25% is our reception, and then the dBm, the signal strength, is minus 121, okay? So this is unplugged, and this is very typical for the cell signal on our property here where we keep the RV. It's not that great, it's pretty weak. Now let's take a look at what that signal strength equates to in terms of real world speed. So here I've just got a speed test running. And you can see here with our current cell phone signal strength, looks like we're downloading right at about 3 megs per second, which isn't horrible, but let's just see what the signal booster does afterward. And then our upload speed is right about 0.2, it looks like, 0.16. Pretty weak actually here. And so this will give us an idea of what our speed looks like without the booster running. All right, so you can see here we got 3.14 for the download speed, 0.21 for the upload speed. And my Wi-Fi is off, obviously, so I'm running just on the cell connection. All right, so let's plug in the cell phone signal booster now and see what a difference it makes on the signal. All right, so again, this is what our signal looks like before the booster's turned on. And now let's go ahead and plug it in. All right, so the green light comes on the booster. And then we'll go back here. And look at that difference. I mean, wow. So now we're up to 86%. And then on the dBm meter, minus 79. I mean, huge, huge jump. Now, I have seen it fluctuate a good bit, just kind of depending on the position of the booster, the internal antenna here, the location of the phone, whether it's laying down or propped up against it, how close it is. But I mean, look at that incredible improvement in the signal right there. I mean, wow, I've never had a signal that good on the property. Now let's take a look at what that does on the speed side. So let's go over here to the speed test again and run another speed test. So now we're connected to the booster with the booster on, and let's see what a difference it makes. Okay, so now we're at about 10 megs for our download speed. I mean, remember before we were about 3. So now we're hovering right around 10 on the download speed. And now let's take a look at the upload. All right, so we got 3, looks like about an average of 3 on the upload speed. That's really a considerable improvement. So remember before we were downloading at about 3 megs, now we're almost up to 10. And then upload before was really pathetic. It was 0.16, I think, and now we're up to 3. So I mean, initially really, really impressed at the results that you can get with one of these signal boosters. I've never gotten a signal this good on our property before. Now let me share just a couple things that I learned personally using this. So first off is the range of this indoor antenna. This is really what reproduces the signal inside your rig. So realistically, you do have to be within a few feet of this indoor antenna, otherwise it's just not going to give you results. So right now you can see I'm pretty much right up to it kissing. Now let me pull it back and let's just see how far it gets and how that impacts the signal. So right now we're probably about 12 inches away, so maybe a small drop, not a real big deal. Let's go a little bit further. All right, so right now we're closer to 2 feet away from the phone. Still not a huge difference. Let's go ahead and just take it away, make it about 3 feet. All right, so now I've got the antenna over there, booster, a little bit of a drop, but still works. Now let's just take our phone and let's start walking away from the internal antenna. So now we're probably about 4 feet away. You can see the signal's dropping just a little bit more. Now we're approaching 5 feet from the antenna. And you can see the signal's dropping a little bit more. We're probably about 6 feet. And so you can see it does make a difference how far you get away from the antenna. So if you're using this like me, and you're basically using your phone as a hotspot, then you're probably gonna wanna just put your phone right next to the antenna inside, turn on that hotspot, and then connect to your computer, you know, through Wi-Fi. And that's probably your best bet. So really impressed with the overall performance of the signal booster, let me show you how easy it is to install. Now the manufacturer gives you this nice visual to give you an idea how to set it up on your rig. So let's start with all the different components. You'll notice here on the outside, there's an exterior antenna, an outside antenna. They've got it on the ladder. They've got a special mount that'll clamp onto your ladder and secure the antenna there. So that's the outside antenna, and that's what's bringing in from the cell tower the signal. All right, then there's an RG6 cable, this orange line here, very similar to your household coax cable. And it's going inside the RV into this green box here. And that is the booster, all right? So that's what we've got here in this compartment. All right, so the external antenna goes into the booster, and then there's another cable that comes out the top, which runs to the internal antenna here. And then last, you've just got power going to the booster. Now they give you a 120 volt AC adapter. They also have a 12 volt DC adapter, which is kind of nice. So since your rig is already natively running off 12 volts, you can choose between the two. I went ahead and wired up both. So I've got my 12 volt right here that runs down below to a 12 volt power lead that I tapped off of. And then I also went ahead and added this 120 volt outlet, and that way I can choose between the two. I think most of the time I'm gonna be running off 12 volts, but I figure if anything goes haywire with the 12 volts, I can real easily plug into 120 volts. So back to the drawing, you can see they have the external antenna all the way on the upper rear corner of the RV, and then there's some separation to the booster and to your internal antenna. Notice how they've got it broadcasting the opposite direction. So I think what they're trying to convey here is you want to have some distance between your outside antenna and your inside antenna. If they're too close, I would suspect that you reduce the effectiveness and how strong it can reproduce that signal. So that's one important observation to make. You want to keep the outside antenna and the inside antenna as far apart as you possibly can. That's going to give you some better results. And that's pretty much what I found here. Now, I think for most people, WeBoost gives you everything you need to complete the install. You've got, of course, the booster device itself that goes inside and connects the two antennas. There's a little plate on the back that you can mount on the wall to keep it secure. There's the inside antenna, the outside antenna. Then they give you some different mast options for that outside antenna to raise it up. They give you one with a spring on it. They also give you the clamp mechanism that clamps the antenna to your ladder, two U-clips basically. Then there's an AC adapter and the DC adapter, so you can choose which one of these. You don't have to do both. In my case, I went ahead and did both just to have a backup, but you only need to choose one of the two. And then they gave you a couple little miscellaneous items, some tie wraps, a little cap for your cable as it goes into the RV on the roof, and a drill bit if you need one as well. So overall, they give you everything you need to complete the install. Now, if you're like me, you're probably a little suspicious about the performance of the product. And so before you even install it, go ahead and just lay it out in your RV. And so for instance, I went through here and just ran the external cable through my slide. If you just open your slide a little bit, run that cable through there and go ahead and position the antenna up on top of your roof. I just used some painter's tape to tape it to the ladder. And then of course I plugged everything in and went ahead and tested it first. And I got really impressive results, just like I showed you a minute ago. And so I decided to proceed with the installation, but definitely test it out first. If you're not happy with the install, try to change up the location of the external antenna. You know, get as much distance as you can from the internal antenna and just experiment. Try it on the back of your rig, try it on the front of your rig, and just see what works best before you go through and actually install it. Now, my install was pretty straightforward and simple. I chose about midship in the rig here in this cabinet to put the booster where everything comes together, the outside, the inside, and the power. And the reason I did that is this is an internal wall in my rig here. And you can see that there's a sink right here, which means there's a vent stack that runs to this wall and goes up to the roof. And there's also a bathroom right behind that wall, so there's another vent stack. So when you go up on the roof, you can see clearly two vent stacks that are exiting the roof. And so I knew they were both going through this wall, and it made it super easy for me on the roof to just pick a spot next to the roof vents and drill down so I could get into the rig and land on this internal wall and not in front of it or behind it. So that's one consideration to think about. You definitely want to pick an internal wall though, because most modern rigs like this one have laminated sidewalls, which means there's solid block foam inside. And so you definitely don't want to try to fish something down solid block foam. The internal walls on your RV, most of them are going to be hollow, with the exception for pipes and some wires. So just a couple considerations to think through. Another thing that really made this install a lot easier for me was choosing to add this 120 volt outlet. When I did that, I was able to cut a hole into my interior wall first for that outlet, which gave me a lot more space to fish wires up and down compared to this small exit hole I use for the outside antenna and the DC power. Now again, right now I've got it connected to DC power, which I was able to run right down here to my converter box where I've got 12 volt power. But I also did do the 120 volt outlet up there as well, just to have as a backup, kind of a nice bonus there. Now the inside antenna has a cord length of about 15 feet, I'd say, and so you can locate it really wherever you want in the rig. What I like about this one being midship is that if I want to take the internal antenna and move it back to the rear of the rig back here, I can. Or if I want to go to the front of the rig, it'll reach almost all the way to the banister here in the front living room area. So that's kind of a nice bonus of putting it midship, is that you can relocate the antenna inside as you need to, because remember, it really is most effective when you're within 2 to 3 feet of that indoor antenna. All right, let me show you the outside install portion here. So we're on the top of the fifth wheel on the very, very back on the roof. You can see the ladder going down there to the back and the external antenna. So they supply that mount with it. It's basically an L bracket with two U-clamps, and it'll clamp right onto your ladder. You can do it in the vertical position like I did there, or if you wanted to do it on your horizontal portion of the ladder, you can flip it and do that as well. Now, at first I wasn't a big fan of the supplied mounting bracket that you can see here, the way it mounts to the ladder. And so I started looking at getting a different mount that would just mount directly to the roof. But then I started realizing they did it for a reason. You know, this whole antenna can probably be a little bit top heavy. And so if you've got it mounted to your roof directly on a single plate, it's probably gonna wanna shear right off in the wind. Whereas this ladder here is supported in multiple places, and obviously it's enough to support me going up and down. And so really connecting it to the ladder is gonna be your best bet. Now let me just say, there are a lot of different ways you can install this product. So I'm showing you mine as an example, but your rig may be different, so you may use a different install method. You can see I went out of the external antenna into half inch conduit. I did that mainly to protect the cable. I also think it makes it look a little bit cleaner on your roof, and it's very inexpensive. So you can see here the conduit runs about midship to those vents up there. Now every time you make a penetration in your RV's roof, you have to use the Dycor lap sealant to cover up those holes to make sure it's waterproof. All right, and then everything terminates into this double gang box here, and you can see the roof vents right next to them. That was the key to knowing where that internal wall was inside the rig. So if you've got a vent stack like that, take advantage of it, especially if the location is ideal for you. I just put this double gang box there, ran the RG6 cable through there, you know, of course siliconed the hole just as a precaution in case any water would get in that box, but it is weatherproof, and then of course the Dycor lap sealant around it. So again, your rig may be different where you have to utilize a different install method, but for me, this really made the most sense to get my antenna all the way in the back there to about midship here where the plumbing vents are. And again, the nice thing about this spring mount that they give you that you can use is that if I were to, you know, run up against some tree branches that are hanging low, it's got a little bit of give on it, so it's not just gonna take the whole antenna out. So in review, if you're researching these cell phone boosters and thinking about getting one, just a couple considerations. First off, wherever you are, you've got to at least have some kind of reception for this to work. If you're out in the middle of the desert and there's no tower nearby, it's not going to magically produce a cell phone signal. So you need to at least have one bar, even if it's a tiny bar cutting in and out, just something to indicate that there is a signal in your area. And then second, just be realistic about the distance from the internal antenna where it will amplify that signal. So for me, I found that really 2 to 3 feet is ideal. You know, the closer the better. And I don't really think that's a problem for most people because you're probably using your phone as a hotspot on the road. And so you just plant your phone next to the internal antenna, put it into the hotspot mode, and then take your laptop and use it throughout the coach, you know, through Wi-Fi, however you need to. And last, I would really stick to one of the major brands that manufactures these products. If you go onto Amazon, you're gonna find a host of different companies and different versions of these cell phone boosters and really a variety of prices in the price range. So I really think sticking to one of the major brands is gonna suit you the best. I think they have developed and researched and fine-tuned this technology. You know, WeBoost from Wilson Electronics, I think they're probably one of the bigger players in the market. They do this just not for RVs, but for buildings, for homes. So I really think they understand, you know, how cell phone waves travel and how to best amplify them. So definitely stick with one of the major brands. Another little tip I'll give you, and this is one hurdle that I had to overcome, was the price on this thing. Most of them that are really good are going to be priced right in the $400 to $500 range, and that seemed kind of steep to me, at least, especially since I'm not full-time in a rig. I'm traveling on vacation with my family from time to time. But what I found is if you watch on Amazon the warehouse deals under the used section, you can get a killer deal. And so I picked up mine for half the price, right around $227 on a warehouse deal. And basically that's where somebody bought the product from Amazon, returned it to Amazon. They inspected it, which, you know, probably means they just made sure the parts were there. They probably didn't actually test it. But then they just rebox it and put it up for sale as used by Amazon. So definitely keep an eye out for those warehouse deals. I mean, I think that's the way to go if you're looking to get into this. And again, before you install it permanently, go ahead and set it up in your rig, just running the cable through a slide or a window, and just see if it works, see if it does what you think it will. All right, that's it for our video today. If you found it helpful, be sure to give me a thumbs up. I will put in the description below affiliate links where you can purchase this exact same booster, the WeBoost Drive X RV, and definitely keep an eye out for those Amazon warehouse deals in the use section to give yourself a bigger discount. If you're not already subscribed, be sure to click that subscribe button. There's going to be some really cool upgrades and mods coming up in the series. And last, leave me a comment below and I'll do my best to check them and respond in a timely fashion. Thanks for watching.